My name is Friedemann Klein. I've been working at the Berlin office of the Qt company for 11 years on various topics like Qt Designer, Qt Creator, the Windows platform plugin of Qt 5, and I recently started on the PySide project. I would like to give you a short overview of the PySide 2 project. PySide 2 provides a set of modules for the Python scripting language, enabling the Qt to be used from Python scripts. This lets you use Qt without having to compile C++ code. It currently supports Python 2 and 3. A little bit of history. It started out as PySide for Qt 4 back in the Nokia days. It is currently being developed by a small team at the Qt company's Berlin office and external contributors. We aim to make it a full first-class citizen in Qt 5. We have a wiki page down here on which you can track progress and also find instructions on how to download, compile, and install the modules. What does it look like in practice? Let's have a look at a little Hello World program in Python. This is a little Qt Hello World application in Python. Note here the Python import statements matching the include directives of C++ application. Further down in the main method, we instantiate a Qt application. We instantiate a label, set some properties on it, show it and call Qt application exec as we would in C++. There's a slight difference here. The method is called exec underscore since exec is a reserved word in Python. When we run it, unsurprisingly, we get a window saying hello world. I'm making use of a lesser known feature of Qt Creator, which is a simple Python project management, which simply lets you list a list of Python files in the file named .pyqtc, and then it is able to run them. What are potential use cases for PySide? You can write entire Qt applications in Python. It is also possible to use it for fast prototyping. You can start out in Python and later on port over to C++. Third, you can provide script bindings for C++ applications. This is comparable to the Visual Basic bindings offered, which are provided by the Microsoft Office applications. One of our customers, Autodesk, is using this for their Maya 3D design application. It is possible to extend Maya by Python plugins and scripts. Let's have a look at some more demos. We have here a web browser in Python, making use of the WebEngine module. We import Qt WebEngine widgets, WebEngine page, Qt WebEngine view, and we create a main window inheriting the Qt main window class. We assemble a toolbar with some buttons, and further down, I set the Qt WebEngine view. Okay, we set a WebEngine view as a central widget. Note here the signal slot connections here. The back button of the browser toolbar is created as a Qt push button. And further down, we connect the method self.back to its click signal, which is available using this syntax. And it's connected to the back method, which invokes some action on the WebEngine view. When we run it, after a while, we get a little web browser with a toolbar providing address and back and forward navigation. Takes a while. Similarly, there are bindings for the Qt multimedia module. This is an example of a little media player. It is also using a Q main window, instantiates a Q media playlist, a Q media player, and also populates a toolbar and a menu with the standard actions. Adds a volume slider, and further down, instantiate a Q video widget and sets it as a central widget. When we run it, looks like this. It looks like a little media player, which allows us to play the Qt 5.9 introduction video with just a few lines of Python code. There are also bindings for the Qt QML module. This is an example from the QML tutorials. It's showing how to overwrite or to re-implement a C++ class in Python. We have a class PyChart inheriting a Qquick painted item, which overrides the paint methods. Near declares a color property, which will be available as a property from QML. Further down, it is registered as a QML type, and it is used in a QMAlpha, which looks like this, basically instantiates two of these pie charts beside each other, and on the mouse click, change the color of the color property of the pie chart. When we run it, we get this QML file to show with this behavior on click, changing the color property. There are also bindings for the Qt chart and the Qt data visualization module. This is an example showing graph from the Qt data visualization module. Qt 3D bar chart is created. It's populated with some axes and with some dummy data. And further down, it is embedded into the widget's main window using a Qwidget create window container. When we run it, we get a 3D bar chart. So this is very useful, for example, for scientific data visualization. If you have scripts processing scientific data, it makes it very easy to add visualization to it. So this was a demo walkthrough. Next, let's take a little look under the hood. To expose C++ classes to Python requires writing a lot of bindings code. In PySide, this is done by a generator which is named gboken2. It parses the C++ headers of Qt using a Clang library and generates the bindings. Now, for this, it is using a configuration language in XML, which I would like to show. This is the generator configuration file for the Qt widgets module. In XML, you list the classes you want to have exposed, you add the enumerations, and it is also possible to modify the function remove arguments or inject additional C++ code. Sometimes it is required to do a little magic, for example, to adjust the ref count of the Python rubber objects to make this work. And this configuration language lets you do this in a flexible way. A future plans. The current working assumption is that we release PySide 2 under the standard commercial or GPL2, LGPL3 license combination in the course of 2018. To sum it up, the use cases for PySide are basically you can write entire applications in Python. It can be used for fast prototyping, moving over to C++ later, and to provide script bindings for the applications, for C++ applications. Some links, the wiki page, as mentioned before, has getting started instructions and project progress, and the code bin can be cloned from code.qt.io. With this, I would like to thank you for your attention, and are there any questions?
Well, thank you, Friedemann.
First, thank you for your talk. Mm-hmm. Actually, I had a couple of questions, so maybe we can then talk later. Mm-hmm. But my main question is, we think of integrating PySide in our application, but what we would like to do is not to write the main application in Python, but have the main application in a C++ application, integrate the Python interpreter, and then maybe from a Python script open some Qt dialogues, and maybe even make some widgets available from our application in this dialog. Is this a scenario that will be supported or is supported?
Yeah, this is actually the third use case I mentioned, provide script bindings for existing C++ application. We have in the examples repository, there's the PySide repository is a super repo containing some submodules or sub-repos, and one of them are the examples. And there is actually an example. Called scriptable application. Oops, it went. Something wrong with the display, but it's not my doing. Basically, this has a main window with some test functions which are exposed, and then this invokes this code generator, Shibokun 2, which I mentioned, to actually generate the bindings. And as it is done in QMake, this requires quite some magic, but it's doable. this is basically an example. It has a Python library, or it links to the Python interpreter library, and then it lets you, or it has a main window with a plain text edit in which you can enter Python code snippets, making use of your application. And this is basically, an example for this application. Also this providing of script bindings for C++ application. So the main is C++, basically, that's the point, I guess.
Thank you for that. And maybe a short, another question is, integrating the Python interpreter is quite hard. But with libraries like PyBinding, PyBind 11 is quite easy. Will there be some support from Qt or PySide to make it easier to integrate the interpreter itself?
No, that's not in the plan currently, since we'll be using this code generator to generate the bindings code. We might look at it later. So the tooling part of it is not quite clear yet. We still have to figure that out in the course of the project.
Yep.
Hi. Two questions, actually. Is it possible to run a PySide on iOS or Android? And is it possible to mix and match C++ and PySide classes in the same project?
Can you repeat the first question, please?
iOS and Android.
Is it an embedded board? Or?
No, just Python for iOS and Android. PySide. Would this work on iOS and Android, basically?
Well, currently, it's a... It's built using CMake, basically, if it's, or it is using CMake, and if it's, and other than that, there shouldn't be any obstacles. We have to consider this. So it's not quite clear at the moment. We can, we are considering it, if that's possible.
And the second question, if it's possible to mix and match C++ and Python classes in the same project?
It, well, one direction is basically making a C++ application scriptable. That would mean accessing or the C++ classes from Python that works. The other way around would require currently basically writing code manually using the Python C API in order to retrieve objects and invoke method. This this is not covered by PySide. You would have to do it yourself.
Any last questions? All right. No, no, we have a question.
So, how does this compare to PyQt?
It's comparable, basically, from the client part, basically, a Python script. Basically, the only noticeable difference is that you import PySide 2 dot widgets instead of PyQt dot widgets. The coverage is PySide currently has a little bit less coverage of Qt, but we are working on it, improving it, extending it. And another difference is that we actually use this code generator to generate the bindings. So we are thinking this is a slight advantage for PySide because it makes it faster to add additional bindings. But the view from the Python user client programmer is basically similar. It's comparable. It's a comparable product.
Thanks.
Okay, we have just 1 minute for one last question.
So you mentioned the C, accessing C from Python. So does this work by compiling to C and then accessing that from Python through that API, or because then I think you could also target other languages that have the possibility to call C functions.
Well, yeah, basically how it works is you have to generate this binding code, which generates a lot of methods, and these methods are then stored as function pointers in some struct, and those are passed to Python, so that Python knows about it. If you want to target other languages, then you have to generate a different binding code, but there are languages which have a similar principle.
No last question, so I would like to thank everybody. Thank Friedemann for being here today with us. Please use the mobile app to give us some ratings also for the talk that Friedemann just had. And I would like to thank everybody for being for this yet another great event, the Qt World Summit 2017. So see you next year. Thank you.